Hello lovelies, welcome to my first cosplay vlog. This is going to be a behind the scenes look at how I made and pieced together my Loki cosplay. I kind of documented and recorded different parts to this cosplay process, and if you guys like this particular style of vlog, then I will probably do it with future cosplays as well. So without further ado, let us get into the Loki cosplay. So starting out with this Loki vlog is kind of my process on how I made the Loki crown or headpiece. Just drawing out the basic outline of what I was going to cut out and create. I pretty much just went with my own plan for this. Originally for this particular cosplay, I wasn't even going to make this headpiece. I had a different thing in mind, but then at the very end, coming up before I was going to do the actual shoot, I decided that I really wanted the headpiece and I still had a couple days, so I went ahead and went for it. This was pretty much my main stencil for the four pieces that I was going to cut out for the little horns, if you will. From there, I traced that same stencil four times onto cardboard. That majority of this headpiece is made out of cardboard. Then I went ahead and started cutting out those four pieces. Four, not two, because I doubled up so that there was a little bit more thickness to the front of the crown. Then taping together at an angle, we have the basic look. This was shaping the headpiece around my head and making sure that it would fit correctly and just making so it was rounded. Also making sure to measure and have where the horns would attach to the front of the headpiece so that it was nice and secure and making sure that it fit my melon. Testing those pieces in and they fit perfectly. And then starting to add in some additional details, I added a few different spots on top to give it a little bit more of the dimension. And from there, I was pretty much adding a layer of newspaper to all of my pieces so that it was a little bit more unified, if you will. Just using some Mod Podge for that. This is my little makeshift drying area we have here. Funny enough, I wasn't going to make a Loki helmet. I was gonna do something else, and then I just decided to freaking do it the other night. So this is, this part will be ready for paint. Well, the first layer of paint, as will the little horn bits that will attach into these slots that I made. I'm gonna do a layer of spray paint before I do regular paint with some detailing, and that's what I'm hoping. That's what I'm going for, that this will work out and everything. While I had everything out, I'm also making that, so you can do with that what you will. Then for some work outside, went ahead and spray painted all of the pieces with a layer of just a yellow spray paint that I had. There's a couple different layers of paint and gloss that I did to this piece, and I did it in different layers so that it gave the right effect that I was going for. Because while the yellow isn't horrible, I did want more of the gold look that Loki has with his piece. And I did a couple different layers because usually with spray paint, you know, thin coats with multiple coats is better than a thick layer, and then it gets all runny and gross. The combination of the newspaper and the different types of tape that I used along the edges made it for a nice smooth surface against the various parts of my face and my head. So just using some of the paint to help mold that together.
All right, so this is the day after painting them, well, spray painting them. There's the first layer to kind of hide, you know, the newspaper and the different layers of things that I've done. I haven't actually connected these yet, but they're gonna go in there. I'm not gonna leave it like this. I'm also going to be doing some additional painting with some, I don't know, just craft paints and different things to add some details. I just wanted yellow or a light color as like a base to start with, and it did add this nice little shine to it. Hopefully it comes together okay. This is kind of like the first thing that I've really been building fully, like wise, cosplay wise. So hopefully it turns out good. I'm loving this belt. I think it's gonna be perfect. Can even go a little tighter if I wanted to for when I have the dress on, but I love how this looks. That's exactly what I was going for.
This is not the color I wanted. We're gonna fix that because no. It's a beautiful day, why not paint outside?
So, a different day of painting, of course, stepping away from the coats of spray paint and moving to some different type of paint and giving kind of the golden look with a few different color mixtures together and just getting a couple different coats on the various pieces before I connect it all together. There was a really specific color that I was going for, like obviously gold, but when you're using different mediums with the spray paint, some of the gloss that I did, and just like the craft paint, I was going for a specific look. So I kind of worked with it with the three pieces, the two horns and the maid head piece. And it was a beautiful summer day while I was doing this, so I did most of my painting on this headpiece just out on my patio. And letting it dry in between little sessions. Now I wanted to emphasize some of the details that I had put onto the crown, the headpiece, for some of the dimensions and angles. So I started out with this copper tone, but then I wanted to make it more subdued, obviously. So this was just kind of like almost a base for a shadow of some of the extra details that had made it a little bit more three-dimensional. From there, I used this spray gloss that made it look more shiny and not dull after the different coats of paint. And that's pretty much what I went with for my Loki headpiece. And of course, attaching the horns. This was one of the first test shots of the pieces together. I originally was going to be using a different jacket, but when I put it together, it didn't look right at all. So I pulled a different one from my closet. And this jacket ended up looking much better with all of the pieces together in just kind of a test run. Also was trying different necklaces, golden necklaces, for what I wanted with the cut of this green dress. And now comes filming day. Makeup time. I of course wanted Loki's colors in my eyeshadow, so golds, multiple greens, and some blacks to kind of do a green smoky eye with golden highlight is the look that I was going for, and I really wanted a darker lip, so it's a combination of a dark green and a black.
Dress. Wig.
Photo shoot time.
Keep looking for people. I need to clean my gutters.
Alright, so I just did, I guess, my first cosplay photo shoot out and about. I was lucky, we went early enough, there wasn't people, I could hear little kids playing, but no one was around or anything, and the spot worked really well for the cosplay, so I'm pretty excited. It matches my aesthetic today. Green straw, yellow drink.
I'm going to film some reels now, back in my office. Reels are some of my favorite thing to do in my cosplays. I should realistically probably make a TikTok or something, but I love different reels and different lines and songs and everything with fitting different characters. So I'm gonna do some Loki reels right now after I get my damn memory card back in my camera.
a little baby Tesseract.
It's time to take the cosplay off. Well, I really don't want to because I'm having a lot of fun with it and I'm really happy with how my headpiece turned out. Went and did the photos out and about. That went well. Came home and did some reels and some other photos. Filmed an ASMR video as Loki. And yeah, now to look over footage and see how it went and everything like that. But this has been a fun one. I like this one. Can't wait for the Loki series.
Thank you guys so much for watching this behind the scenes of my Loki cosplay. All of the cosplay pictures and reels are over there on my cosplay Instagram, Call Me Canary Cosplay. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.